So let me start by saying, luckily, mucormycosis, which is also known as the black fungus, so far has not been detected in pediatric COVID. So children who have suffered from COVID or are suffering from COVID, as of now, we don't have pediatric cases reporting mucormycosis. So that's a sigh of relief that every parent should breathe. But on the other note, what is mucormycosis is very important to know. What we call as spores of mucormycosis are basically commensals cells in everybody's nose. So you'll be shocked to know that all of us already have spores of mucormycosis in our nose on regular basis. So it's there, it's living peacefully. It's a symbiotic relationship between your nasal mucosa and the mucormycosis spores. But what has happened in COVID is because for some unknown reason, when you get the COVID virus, your immunity drops in the form of low counts, low platelets. So these spores, which are otherwise friendly spores living in your nose, they take this opportunity to start growing. And that's when you get infected with mucormycosis. So any form of drop in immunity, the surprising thing is in the first wave, there were hardly any cases. There were cases, unreported cases of mucormycosis, but the first variant of the first wave did not cause so much of immunosuppression, that is, drop in counts and immunity. This B.1.617 causing the second wave is dropping immunity in healthy individuals, 31-year-olds, 41-year-olds getting admitted with mucormycosis. So we know for sure that this variant is extremely, extremely strong and virulent in destroying the immunity of the host. So that's when the spore takes this opportunity to grow. Second group of individuals are diabetic people who already have high sugars and low immunities. And third individuals are those who have been given unnecessary steroids, which temporarily drop their immunity and gives those spores living in your nostrils, which are there airborne everywhere, but otherwise are harmless. Only this situation is there when they take an opportunity to grow. They grow upwards, they grow into your sinuses, they grow behind your eye, they go into your brain, they go down to your throat. So the red flag is usually within the second or third week of recovery of COVID. A highest number of mucormycosis cases are being seen. Starts with epistaxis, bleeding from the nose. It grows upwards into the sinuses, causing severe frontal sinusitis and headaches. By the time there is blurry vision, by the time there is eye pain, it's already a bit too late because it's grown towards the eye and reduces and nearly, causes tremendous amount of eye pain and then eventually loss of vision. A lot of my ENT friends are currently operating in removing the infected eye so that it prevents the spread of going to the brain. Because once it reaches the brain, it tends to get a little scary and fatal for the patient. So my point here is not to scare anybody in the city of Bombay, but this is what mucormycosis is. Research also shows that there are a huge number of cases in our municipal hospitals like Nair, KM, Sion of mucormycosis currently. But as my colleagues inform me, that they are not locals from Mumbai. They are people from interiors of Maharashtra who have come down specially for this treatment. So in urban cities like Delhi and urban cities like Mumbai, the urban population is not getting it. It's the rural population which is coming to the urban centers because of getting infected there. Possibly because of low hygiene levels there, possibly because of, using unnecessary steroids there. So if the treatment protocols are not proper, unnecessary steroids are used, this fungus takes an opportunity and grows. So we are a little, wary about this current scenario of mucormycosis in our cities. It's there, the cause of which is still under study. But one thing that, I sleep well at night right now, knowing that it's not infecting or affecting children as of now.